Hello guys, hola, bon dia. My name is Petra, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about things I wish I knew before I came to study abroad in Porto, Portugal. For those of you who don't know me, I was studying abroad in Porto, Portugal last semester, which means from the February 2020 until June 2020. So in February, everything was still working normally, so I feel like I have gotten some accurate study abroad experience. However, I have also experienced what it's like to study abroad during the corona pandemic. So if you're interested in that, I can definitely provide you some insight. I was studying at the Catholic University of Porto, aka Universita Católica Portuguesa. It was a very lovely university. It is a private university, it is not too big, and it is located in Foz, which is the area nearby the beach. In February, I was just normally attending the classes at Católica, and from like middle of March, we had to stop going to school, so we didn't go to school anymore. And from like 21st of March, we started to have online classes. Católica was really good at starting the online classes. I think we were one of the first schools who started the online classes. I know that some of my friends from the University of Porto, it took them much longer to start the online classes, so I'm really grateful for that. The teachers are really nice, they are always willing to help you, and yeah, I just had a really good experience. Anyways, let me now tell you the things I wish I knew before I came to study abroad in Porto, Portugal. First thing that I wish I knew is that the school in Portugal is not that easy. It is definitely much harder than I expected. Usually here at my home university in Czech Republic, the exchange students have it much easier than us Czech students. So it was really surprising to me when I found out that the Portuguese teachers are not going to give us any special treatment. They just treat us the way how they treat the Portuguese students. The Portuguese students have an option to attend the course either in English or in Portuguese. A lot of my courses I would attend with other Portuguese students as well. Another thing that you should probably be aware of is if you have a little bit less mainstream major. For example, I study finance and accounting, so it's a little bit more mainstream, or if you study business administration, you will probably have no issue at all. But if you study something like biotechnology, some sort of chemical things, or something more rare, it can probably happen that you might have some courses in Portuguese as well. Of course, the teachers will provide you some materials in English, but sometimes the lectures will be in Portuguese. Know that this can happen to you. I had some friends that they would have to attend a lecture in Portuguese, or they wouldn't have to attend, but the only lectures that were available to them were in Portuguese, and they would only get some sort of materials that they had to study in English, but they wouldn't have any courses in English. So yeah, just be aware of it. Also, some universities have really long lectures. For example, my university, Católica, we had a workshop and a 3-hour long lecture for each class. Some of my friends from the other universities, they didn't have these long lectures, so I think it's just a Católica thing. So if you are going to Católica, brace yourself because you are gonna have 3-hour long lectures. Enough with the bad news. I hope that I didn't discourage you guys way too much. I promise the rest of this video is going to be much more positive. And also, if you already know that you are going to study abroad in Portugal, know that it's okay. I still had a really good time, even though the school was hard, you know, so don't worry, you will be fine. The second thing that I didn't expect at all, perhaps I have been living under a rock, but I just didn't really look into this kind of things, is that there are so many events organized for the exchange students. There is this organization called ESN, Erasmus Student Network, in Porto, and they organize a lot of trips, a lot of parties, a lot of activities for the exchange students. You guys can easily just Google about it. It's called ESN Porto. I will link it down below and you can just browse their website. However, right now, I don't think that there are any events happening because of the coronavirus. Basically, the way how it worked before the virus is that you went to the rectorate of the University of Porto. It is in the center. And you brought your passport or your ID and 10 euros and they would register you there and you would get like a card, ESN card. And then you would just browse their website and search for different events and see what events you would like to attend. And then you would just register for the events online and then go to the rectorate and pay for the event because for some reason you couldn't pay online. But yeah, that's how it worked. But now I don't think it works anymore because of the virus. But hopefully if you're watching this in the future, maybe it will start working like this again. Also, they have these group chats on WhatsApp. You guys can join them. And I think it's great if you need an advice or something, you can just text them to the group chat. ESN also has a group on Facebook where people sometimes post accommodation advertisements. So if you guys are interested, you can check it out as well. The third thing that I wish I knew is that the apartment location matters. Back in February, I would spend so much time waiting for a bus. And it was because I lived in this area where I would have to take two buses to get to school. Porto is full of one-way streets, so there is a lot of traffic, and that's why the buses are always late. To give you guys a little context, according to Google Maps, from my previous place to school, it should take around 40 minutes. But once I would literally leave my home at 9 and to go to a class at 11, and I would still come late. That's why I would highly recommend to you guys to get an apartment where you don't need to transfer buses. I think it's okay if you have to take a metro and a bus. I think that's not as bad. But if you have to take two buses, that's recipe for disaster. So definitely I would choose an apartment where you only have to take one bus. Also, if you are planning on going out, I would highly recommend to choose a place that is not so far from the city center, because then it could be expensive to get back. For example, if you go to Católica, I wouldn't recommend you to get a place in Foš, because that is too far from the center. I would recommend to you to get something between the center and school, such as Casa Musica, for example, where it's the same kind of distance to the center and to school. I think that's like the ideal area. Or you can get a place in the city center, which is really nice. I used to live between Boliao and Campo 24 Augusto, and that was really good location. I really liked it. Also, I thought it would be helpful to mention an average cost of rent. So an average cost of renting a room in Porto is from 250 to 350 euros a month. Maybe now after the coronavirus it might get cheaper, but when I was there it was around 300 euros. Some places where you can find accommodation is, for example, Student at Home. It is basically a website where you can find a room that you can rent. Also, there is UniPlaces. It is basically the same thing as Student at Home, but they have much more options. Then there's also this organization called InLife, which gives you a tour of the apartment before you rent it. And lastly, there are also Facebook groups, such as the ESN Facebook group that I already mentioned, but there are definitely much more groups. So yeah, you can definitely also find some accommodation on Facebook. Another thing I wish I knew is regarding public transportation. If you are below a certain age, I believe it's around 24, you get this paper from your school, which is basically like a student discount for your public transportation. And you fill out this paper and you give it to the people when you are applying for your transportation card. The price of public transportation is around 20 euros a month for free zones and around 30 euros a month for all zones. I would highly recommend you to get all zones. Another thing that I found kind of strange is that you can only purchase the transportation from the 1st until the 30th. If you arrive to Portugal in the middle of the month, it's maybe not worth it to get the monthly transportation thing, because it's going to be valid only from until the 30th. If you know what I mean, you cannot just get it from 15th until 15th the next month, but you will get it from the 15th until the 30th, and it's going to be costing the same as from the 1st until the 30th. Also, FYI, an individual ticket is usually around 2 euros. When you take a bus, you go through the first door and you can purchase a bus ticket for 2 euros. During my first few days, I definitely wished I knew where I could go shopping. So let me now share with you some of my favorite shopping places. There's this street called Rua Catarina. There are a lot of stores there, so you can get basically anything there. Also, there's this shopping mall called Via Catarina Shopping Mall, so there is also a lot of stores where you could go. Also, there's this big shopping mall called Norte Shopping, where it's literally everything, so I am sure that you will definitely find what you're looking for in Norte Shopping. Unfortunately, my camera is dying, so I need to hurry up. But lastly, I would like to share with you some insights on day trips. Portugal is such a beautiful country and there are definitely a lot of nice places to see, even outside of Porto or Lisbon. There is a lot of amazing places that you can visit. There is this car rental company where you can get a discount with your ESM card. I will link it down below. The cost of renting a car is around 35 to 45 euros, plus you need to pay for the gas. And also we need to pay for the highways, and also we need to pay for taxes for the highways. You need to go to a post office and pay for the taxes. Some beautiful day trips are, for example, Aveiro, Braga, Coimbra. There are also a lot of national parks, for example, the Gerês National Park, and also Serra da Estrela National Park, very beautiful. And also, you can go for a road trip to Algarve, Faro, and to the south, because it's also really beautiful. A lot of people went there and they really loved it. I personally didn't go there, but I would highly recommend, if you have the opportunity, definitely visit the Algarve area. So guys, that's it for this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. I am definitely planning on making one more video about Porto. I would like to make a video about my favorite places in Porto. So yeah, if you like this video and you would like more videos about Portugal, definitely give this video a thumbs up. I hope that this video was useful to you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!